Chris, the question of the day seems to be if Dwight is going to come back. Do you think he will be back for next season?
It's hard for me to say. I know in my heart that this is a place where I think he should be. And we have a great legacy, great history of great players in this city that he backed when the franchise came here in 1960. And he certainly fits the mold. But I don't want to get ahead of the game and take anything for granted. He's been in the league a long time. He's earned his stripes, so to speak, when it comes to making a decision. Playing a contract out to the very end is risky. So he's earned the right to make a decision, an informed and timely decision. So obviously I'm hopeful and I'm optimistic. And from what I understand, although I didn't get a chance to listen to much of the players' interviews to this point, our players that came in today were very supportive of him returning. So that's our hope as of today.
What did he say that gives you, what did he say that gives you optimism that he would return?
Well, we had a long chat, and I wouldn't share with you, you know, any particular thing he did say, but over the course of the discussion, I had a good feeling. And it's not so much, you know, what we spoke about. If you just look at the opportunity, which is to play for this franchise in this city, with what this franchise has meant to the city and its accomplishments, that's probably the most any team can offer a player. Certainly, some players might not prefer to play on a stage like in Los Angeles, but I do know that this franchise will continue to be run as a model franchise. I think this is a very desirable place for players to play. You know, our planning to date will allow for us to have financial flexibility going forward. And I think we can get players to come to Los Angeles, and I think this is a place where players want to come to. So those are really, and I guess what it comes down to is being comfortable selling the Los Angeles Lakers. And that's where my confidence lies the most.
Mitch, Dwight said that, you said that you are going to pressure him and make any kind of decision. Is that normal protocol for you, or are you just sort of reading that situation relative to
him? When we brought him to Los Angeles last August, that's what I told him. You know, there's really no reason to pressure him. You know, from a business point of view, it doesn't make sense to sign a contract until July. You know, he gets the extra percentage year to year, and he gets the extra year. So you'd be pressuring somebody to do something he can't do. It makes no business sense.
But now, you know, coming into this free agency period where he is going to get the year,
I think he understands that the sooner he makes a decision, the better it is for everybody. Now, I don't know if that means a week, a month, or 7 weeks. But I think he understands that the sooner, the better for everybody. It allows us to plan. It allows him to, you know, start putting down roots in the city. People can no longer say, I wonder what he's going to do. Is he going to be gone? He could establish business relationships, you know, foundation, community, charity relationships in the city. So it goes without saying, the sooner, the better. And we're going to support what we said last August. And we're going to abide by our position. And we're going to encourage, you know, him to make his decision in a timely fashion. And we're hoping that he chooses to stay in Los Angeles.
Mitch, did he give you any rough sense at all of the timeline?
No. I kind of walked him through, you know, the next 6-7 weeks. You know, for example, in basketball, in our business, the next thing that takes place is the lottery. And then the teams in the lottery, the positions are determined. So now everybody knows who's drafting where. And then, you know, the phones start to ring in because you have things that are set in stone. And then as you approach the draft, there's a lot of activity. And then, of course, there's July 1st, which is even more activity with free agents and continued trades. So he understands the timeline. Players typically don't understand that until it's explained to them. And I think it's something that was new to him. But it comes down to the same thing. The soonest that he's comfortable.
Yo, this your boy Dwight Howard, a.k.a. Superman, and you're watching LakersNation.com, baby. Yeah!